this tutorial, we cover connecting to WPI's terminal server. This is useful for finding and using software that you do not own, will not work on your operating system, such as Windows software on a Mac, or do not have on the computer you are currently using. The terminal server is available from both WPI-owned and personal computers, on and off campus. VPN software is no longer necessary when connecting to the terminal server in either Mac OS or in Windows. To connect to the terminal server from a Windows operating system, click Start, and then select Remote Desktop Connection. If this does not show up in your Start menu, you can find Remote Desktop Connection under the Accessories folder in all programs. Type windows.wpi.edu into the box labeled Computer and click Connect. A dialog box asking for credentials should appear. If you are connecting from a non-WPI computer, select Use Another Account and log in with your WPI email address and Windows password. If you are logging in from a WPI-owned computer, simply type your Windows password into the appropriate box and click OK. A warning window may appear to tell you that the identity of the remote computer cannot be verified. Click Yes to continue. A blue screen entitled WPI Administrative System, Authorized Use Only, should appear. Click OK to accept the acceptable use policy. To connect to the terminal server for Mac OS X Leopard, first, make sure that the Microsoft Remote Desktop Connection for Mac program is installed on your computer. If you have Office 2011 installed, RDC is included. Otherwise, you will need to install it separately before proceeding. Click the Spotlight magnifying glass icon in the top right-hand corner of your screen and type Remote Desktop Connection into the search box. Select the Remote Desktop Connection application from the list that appears. In the text box labeled Computer, type windows.wpi.edu and click Connect. A dialog box should appear asking for your credentials. Enter admin/, followed by your WPI username in the box labeled Username, and your Windows password in the box marked Password, then click OK. A window may appear to warn you that the server name on the certificate is incorrect. Click Connect to continue. A blue screen entitled WPI Administrative System, Authorized Use Only, should appear. Click OK to accept the acceptable use policy. You can now use the terminal server as if you were using a WPI public lab computer. When you're finished using it, be sure to log off by choosing Log Off from the Start menu. Thank you for watching, and have a wonderful day.